Hello. It's Vegan Alive. Soon. So please start joining. Yeah, hi. Hello everyone. Thank you so much. Please start joining. We're going to have a conversation with Rohit. Thank you. I'm gonna start sharp at 12:30. Yeah, hi Rohit. Yeah, I'm gonna add you in some time. So let's start. Makam asa nahi zindagi ka banana. Makam asa nahi zindagi ka banana. Jab har mod pe ek khai si ho. Jo paar kar jate hain ye khai, asa nahi unko mitana. So hamare jo aaj ke guest hai, unki zindagi bhi isi tarika. Apne hi sharton pe manaya hai. चाहे वो उनका एक लाइफस्टाइल हो जिंदगी का जीने का, चाहे वो उनके डिजाइन हो या उनका कंटेम्पररी कट्स हो। सो लेट्स वेलकम रोहित वर्मा टू द हाय रोहित, हाउ आर यू?
इट्स सो नाइस टू सी यू।
ओह यस, सच अ लॉन्ग टाइम। हाउ इज एवरीथिंग गोइंग?
एवरीथिंग इज लॉक्ड डाउन, लाइक बॉम्बे इज रियली यू नो स्ट्रगलिंग एंड लाइक वी ऑल आर लॉक्ड डाउन. Cases are getting increased over here, so like it's a bad scene here.
Yeah, everybody's stuck at home, and I think can you use headphones, Rohit, if it's possible? Do you have?
Darling, I don't use headphones.
Actually, so up sort of volume, sort of something, because it's echoing.
Wait a second.
Yeah.
Is it better now?
Yeah, echo ho raha hai.
Is it better?
No, thoda volume low.
I have low end on the very. Is it better?
Yeah, it's better. Yeah. Thank you so much, Rohit. First of all, joining Tea Time Talks with Tarang, and this is the third episode. And we have been calling a lot of different people from different you know, their genres are both the same. So you are the firm decider here, and I would like you to welcome. And after personality, let's start from the big picture. Okay, after your personality, you have different face, or you have made your mark on the industry. चाहे वो बिग बॉस हो, चाहे वो डिफरेंट सीरियल्स अब टीवी पे आते हैं वो. So how did you start? I think you started at the time when you were in teens. So how was it?
I come from a very intellectual family background, you know, coming from the background where you have got all the literature people. It was a very big thing and a very serious when I opted fashion and designing, because that time and during the times of 90s that I'm talking about, or 80s, you know, fashion designers are always termed as tailors. So I started, and I'm coming from a literature background. I was very, very skeptical to tell my dad that this is what I want to do. This is what my happiness lies. And my father was very, very against of me being done, because I was always a very black sheep of my family, because I was never good in studies. I was always a bad bencher. So, but I had always my creative skills to it. So my dad, when I broke down in front of my dad, I said, Dad, this is what I want to do. oh my God, it was a big hangama. And my father said, no, my son will not become a tailor. My dad wanted me to go for civil services or go for railways. Well, he's a retired DRM from railways. So. But I always lived my life with my terms and my conditions. And I said, no, because this is my happiness, it's my life. And I will choose my career and what is my happiness. And this is the way I want to be. And this is my happiness lies over here. And that's the reason when I started. My mother helped me a lot, and I started small courses like batik printing and clay modeling, tie and dye, and I did, and that's how my journey started in 1996 after my 12th, and ran away from my house and came to the city of dream, which is Mumbai, and ever since there is no looking back in my career. My my aunt, my master supported me a lot. She paid for my fashion designing fees. And that's how my journey started in Bombay City. So, yes, it was a roller coaster for me. It was a tough time. But yes, I always believe that if you want to do certain things in life, I think you have your heart and you have to be very, very sure what you want to do.
Yes, definitely.
You should not regret taking your decisions. Yeah, that's very important.
बिल्कुल सही बात बोल रहे हैं. You should not regret your decisions like that you make. And आपने जब starting की journey बोला, who was there with you in the starting when you had started doing your designing? I think your sister has really supported you well, right?
No. My best friend supported me well. My best friend Millie, who's based in Dallas, and. She has been my godmother, and she's the one who supported me, because when I came out of the closet and I spoke about my sexuality, this is what I feel, and she was the first one I confessed her, and she's the guy, like it's you can say every successful man has got a woman behind. I'm successful because my friend was behind me, so like she I think I'm sorry the guests at home, so you know how it is. So she's the one who really helped me out, and of course my friends, and like she has done a lot for me. Like I owe her my this life, and because she sacrificed her career for me. Because I was studying designing, she said to make me a designer, she sacrificed her career as a designer because she never wanted any competition between me and her.
That is so sweet of her.
And very less people in the world that are. See, I'm very blessed with a very beautiful friends. So, yes, and that's about it. And that's how my journey started. And my sisters, my family came much more later in my life when I became very established. So my eighth struggle in Bombay City was like she was throughout supporting me.
Okay. So one more thing, actually, this is maybe a personal question, but many people just really want to know about it also. You are a totally different person, you know, your personality is different. So how was your family reaction to it? How did they accepted you? How did they felt about it?
I don't know. My family has never spoken about my sexuality directly on my face. But, you know, now the situation is completely very different from the Instagram. I've got my brothers and sisters also, they have not on my face spoken to me, but I'm very vocal about my sexuality. And when I entered the Big Boss house, I entered the gay contestant. So obviously it's a national television when you're talking about your sexuality openly. And my father came to know, but... they have never, we have never sat on across the table and we have spoken. So, but obviously, I think acceptance in society is very, very important, because during that time, the idea was not very strong. There was no Facebook in 1996 when we are talking about, you know, people never used to talk about sexuality in front of the parents. But later on, when the media became stronger and the whole world started supporting LGBT community, especially coming from the India, which is so difficult to digest the people like us, and accepting and talking about your own sexuality, you need to have a balls. And I've always been a woman or a man with the balls. I've never hidden my sexuality Because if anybody will accept me, they will accept me the way I am. And more than anything else, your work should speak. You know, I'm a good designer.
Yes.
You know, good designer. I mean, God, Lord Krishna has always blessed each and every individual with one kind of an art. So I've always been very vocal. I've always been, trust, love, and respect, these three phenomena I've, you know, carried in my life. And I always believe that just what is beauty is all about. This is the way you are. And if you give to the world the best, always remember the best will always come back to you.
That is so true. If you give your best, then always the best is going to come back to you. And it depends upon your personality also. You know, that you have that kind of charisma in you. And
thank you.
Your speech, you have a contemporary design. I always love the way you see the cutting and all. All these things come into your mind.
You will not be Taranji. You will not believe, I never ever plan my collection. All right. Automatically, the kapra fabric comes in front of me. Automatically, I think it starts like I start draping a mannequin and I start doing something different and collection comes up. Like Sindoor Tila was just like a thought process, what I did for Bombay Times Fashion Week. And it became like a super duper hit show because of the theme. Yes, it's like a theme. It's about the Durga. It's about the Mata. It's about women. It's about the woman empowerment. It's about the acid victims. So, you know, like, I always keep on, you know, doing my research I implement on my clothes. I don't plan my collection like that.
Yes.
It just randomly happens.
Yes, I had seen lots of collections, and it was such a fortunate, in sense that I was also able to host you here in the USA, and it was a fabulous show at that time. So, I want to know about how did you get this fashion movie? And what was there in your mind? Is that okay? Because this is fashion, and you should give your best to it, you know?
You know what? I wanted to become an interior decorator, okay? And I opted for interior decoration first, but my maths is not very good. I have been a very weak student when it comes to maths. So elevation and all was not my thing because, like I said, I'm very vocal. Academically, I was a very average student. But, you know, I thought, okay, where my happiness lies? Because I was not getting satisfied by doing interiors and like... And then I decided that, I think fashion is something which excites me. So I decided to become fashion designer when I was in standard 8. I decided that this is what I want to do. But I was very petrified and horrified to tell my father about it. So I think creativity, like a lot of people do fashion designing, if they think, oh, it's a very fashionable subject. Rather watching Saas Bahu serial, do a fashion designing. A lot of people, you know, think like that. But it's a very serious and a very like a tough subject, you know, because there are a lot of varieties to it. There's a lot of hard work to it. Making a garment, anybody can make a garment, but selling is the main thing. What a consumer want today, what they're looking for. It's something which you need to study. And I leave it on Lord Krishna's lotus feet and he keeps on guiding me and my struggles will become less. And my sexuality always worked positive when it came to my profession. So when I started talking about my sexuality to people, I was the first Indian, one of the Indian in an issue still who came out of the closet and spoke about my orientation toward the world. And people really, really appreciated it. But I believe that nobody's running your kitchen, Taranji. You are running your own kitchen. So you have to live your life the way you want. You can trust anybody. And if anybody will want to love you, he's going to accept you and love you the way you are.
Yes. It has to be. It has to be. You have to love a person, not what exactly he's going through in his mind or what sexuality he has.
Exactly.
His work also.
And so, you know, a lot of people look down upon... A lot of people look down upon transgenders in our country. A lot of people look done about LGBT community, but you know, the most creative people, the most talented people are the transgenders and like LGBT community. And you know, life is not qualified, Taranji, by fluent English or a rich lifestyle or a branded clothes. Life is measured by the numbers of people smile after hearing your name. And you know, yeah, that my strength has never come lifting the weight in the gym. My strength has come within my own self whenever life has knocked me down. So, you know, I have been a very positive person myself. So I believe in karmas. I believe in only spreading the word love, which has got no gender. And that was all reflected in my clothes. That's why I talk in all my interviews that, you know, you have to believe in yourself. You have to believe you're within yourself, that how beautiful you are inside.
Yes. So, and you are a true believer of Krishna also. I've seen you so many times.
A very strong believer.
You were the first one. You were the first one who started writing that Hare Krishna and on the clothes. And there was a little bit controversy. But now
I was arrested.
That, you know, and everybody loves to wear that Hare Rama, Hare Krishna.
Yes, it
How
was my friend. It feels great that your print became so famous in not nationally, also internationally. A lot of international designers started doing wearing Hare Rama Hare Krishna Kurta. It's a one way or form of spreading your Lord's name into the international market. I was arrested along with Sonali Bendre and Lavinia Radio. We all were arrested, but finally we won the case against against the Bajrang Dal. So yeah, and but I think so. You know, when you walk on the streets, it's not like that everybody will appreciate you. There are some people who want to put you down also. So it's very important for you to understand your inner strength, understand who you are and what is your beauty inside. And that's what you reflect to the world, you know, and the world will start respecting you. If you don't respect your own self, the world will respect you. So I have always held high, standing tall in heels and projecting myself. And there I am. And look at Shamita laughing there.
What all talks we are doing, you know, that Pirani
yes.
Baate nikal ke aate.
Yes.
So I want to talk to you about Taj Mahal concert. That was a very famous show, actually.
Style trip, yes.
Yeah.
So when I came out of the Big Boss, I was loaded with a lot of projects. And yep. I saw the style strip happen in my kitty. It was a show where I was slamming all the Bollywood stars who were doing fashion faux pas on the red carpet. But yes, the show was very controversial, but it really worked for me. I was hosting a lot of events. I slammed Shilpa Shetty, I slammed Shamita Shetty, I slammed all the Bollywood people. They were doing it. So whenever I used to be on like red carpet, people used to get scared of me. Oh God, we need to talk about it. But eventually, it came good. I also used to talk good about them when you are doing, because you know, today when you are a public figure, you become a youth icon. People look upon you. They want to see how you are eating, what are you wearing. If I am doing some clothes, you know, you might not like Taranji, but if Shilpa is wearing it, or Shilpa is wearing, or Asuran, what I'm wearing in any of the red carpet, and you want a similar garment. So Bollywood is a thing which plays a very important role. The Bollywood stars plays a very important role. So that's the reason, you know, this whole style strip was all about. It was about style, it was about fashion, it's about critic, it's about the goods, bad, grooming. I used to pick up anyone from the street and used to make them a modern woman. And plus, I used to enter like a cob in people's house and burst their wardrobe, removing the best five outfits and taking the best five outfits of the season. So yes, it was a fun show. It was
a great show, and a lot of people have followed that after that, after you had done it, you know, that a lot of people have started similar shows that kind of, but you have a different class and a different style of presenting that.
Thank you, Taranji.
So how was your journey to the Big Boss also? Big Boss, when you went inside the Big Boss, house, you were doing a lot of things, a lot of drama was happening, and you had to be in the
See, I entered Big Boss to win the show, because I have seen the season 1 and season 2. They are the first one who removed the game contestant out. You know, they throw them out within one go. So I entered with a lot of style when it comes to my clothes, when it comes to my styling, when it comes to my bitchy nature, when it comes to like you know, creating a controversy. It's all about what you give to the show. And I was paid very, very well, and I really needed money, Taranji, that time, because I was not doing very professionally very well. And I really needed money. And Big Boss, the only platform which gave me a lot of money, so I had to survive with this show. And that's why I survived for so long. And Big Boss is all about how unique you are, how unique is your personality, how much India, you're entertaining India. That's what it's all about. So that's why it worked for me. But I entered like a six-year-old boy, and I came out like an old man, because I always believe that you cannot make your own castle in somebody else's emotions. You know, that's a very godparent person. I lost few friends, but today I'm the only person, Big Boss, from the content, who's in touch with everybody. They all come for my birthday parties. They all come for my, like, all my events and my house for dinners. And I made relationship for lifelong. It took me 5 years to say sorry to them, because whatever I did in the game, in the form of game. But they all love me today. They all come from a fashion show and like, and I say life is very strong. You cannot keep a grudge against each other. So it's something which is very beautiful. It's something which is very unique. So Lord has given everybody a very perfect kind of a nature. You only have to spread the word love.
Yeah, don't you think that all these pros and cons what happens in your life, you know, that all different things which happens into your life really grows you mature, gives you a lot of patience also.
I'm so blunt, na. I land up into controversy. पता नहीं मेरे को क्यों फंसा देते हैं ये लोग मीडिया वाले. पता नहीं. I have no idea. I talk from my heart. You know, I cannot be diplomatic. For me, the color black is a black, white is a white. There's no shade of gray inside me. So I cannot be diplomatic. You know, if I have got certain problems, I will be very blunt on the face. And a lot of people don't appreciate that if someone is so can be so blunt and honest in life. So I think that sometimes reflects you back, but I cannot be politically correct in inverted commas, you know, because under the day you need to be blunt. You need to. I cannot be psychophantic. I cannot lick people's asses or anything, you know. If my work is good, it's fine. You know, I have my own experiences, and somehow I always land up into controversies. I don't know why.
When people are not that very blunt, they always end up into the controversies, and that is the truth of the life. You know that it's very common, and it's every it is with everyone also. You only have a lot of tours in US, Canada. Last tour you came here, and so what all do you present here? What is there in your mind?
I have studied the US market very well, and I think people over there are very experimental and touchable. In USA, it's the most important thing I have noted. Who's hosting you is very important. It's very important who hosts you and where are you landing. I have had some bad experiences also where I have landed up into some Diwali Mela or some Eid Mela where people mobbed me and they were just tearing my clothes off and all. But end of the day, what happens, you know, client is a client, and every client has got different budgets. Every client, I have got different kind of mindset. So when I came initially to America, I was not knowing the market well, and that's the reason I've carried some expensive collection which people were not looking at. I made my money. I was not. It was a bad tour for me. But when I came for the second time, I came much more mentally prepared that what people and what are there. Likes and dislikes, and which area you are catering to, and which area you are entering and penetrating is very, very important. And that's how the entire US tour, you know, I pre-planned and everything. And you have to carry from the age group of 17 to the age group of 75. You know, you don't know who is going to come to your stall and what all they can expect. You have to have a varieties. You know, I cannot put my foot down because everybody don't have balls to dress up like Kangana Ranaut or Sonam Kapoor. You want Shabana Azmi and Rekha also. So you have to cater for everybody. So that's all the US was all about, and that's all your. That's the reason, you know, you need to understand your clients very well. Your clientele is very important, and you have to satisfy them. Pricing has to be very good. Because the moment you get the pricing, you will fall flat and your stuff will come back. So I have studied the US market, and LA is a good market. New York is very good. Like Long Island clients are very nice. Yeah. And a couple of areas in America is very, very, like, I was, Phoenix was very good for me. New Orleans was very good. So I have done well. So US has been a good market for me.
Okay. Did you ever thought of doing just the bridal show here in USA? Have you ever thought of doing that?
I thought bridal becomes too personal because when you come to India, if you are carrying 15 to 20 lehengas, you know, and art is very cheap, it's expensive, and the lehenga starts range from $5,000 onwards. I think nobody buys lehenga there, and if you take so much of stuff all the way, such heavy 8 and 9 kgs lehenga, you spend so much money in Korea, or you are doing your tour within the country, and even if your two lehenga is not getting sold, is all your stuff is coming back to the high end the lehenga. That's the reason I'm more considering more threat of $100, $250, $500, up to $1,200 to $1,500 you can sell easily. What I have noticed, the moment the clothes goes above $2,000, I think they all get diarrhea. They don't want to buy.
Because everybody thinks, "Arey, India chale jayenge, India jaake buy kar lenge."
But unfortunately, Taran didi, unfortunately, India is no more cheap. By the way,
no, India is not cheap at all. But they just feel ki mujhe itni variety yahan dekhne ko mil rahi hai. Maybe I will be able to see lot of variety in India. Yes.
And bridal becomes very, very, you know, it becomes, shut up. So bridal becomes very, 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 very personal. It becomes very personal, and when I go to New Jersey market, I've seen these designers are selling bridal $500,000-$700,000 when they are selling bridal from Farukabad. So they finished the competition completely, and they were high end bridals. So people who are high end clients, they will buy. That's a very high risk, you know. Yeah, if somebody is inviting it. Professionally to a bridal show, I will definitely do a show. I'm not against of not doing the show. But selling point of view, see, whatever you display on the runway, wrap is a very different thing. I can do my high-end gowns also. But I don't think that anybody will buy it.
People should understand that the designer is a designer. He has given his thoughts into it. He's just throwing something new to the market. So if you're imitating something that's in the market and you're selling it at a cheap price,
I agree. But every day you get, see, my replica is very difficult to do it. Mere to nahi, main to bacha hua. But sab Manish ke sab ke replica mil rahe hain sab ke paas. Main bach gaya hu abhi tak. You know, because the kind of
thing.
Because मेरे कपड़े बहुत tough है copy करना. It's not very easy. क्या वो कहेगा कि आया है इसका copy करूँगा तो मैं एक piece बनाऊँगा दिन में. इससे तो सबसे सच्ची copy करो मैं 200 बना लूँगा. You know, so that mindset is there. Because even my lehengas are very unique and different. But दो दो तीन तीन दुपट्टा यहाँ से आ रहा है वो पूरा तमाशा और veil के साथ. You know, I do drama brides. But the thing is that, you know, doing a show, doing a proper fashion show with somebody inviting you to do in America, then you get your couture clothes, you know. And you have to come in the mandir, boss, mera kapda bikne wala nahi hai, $10,000-$15,000 ka. And tum jao display karke aa jao, aur apna wo bikinga tumhara wahi $500 to $1,500 ki range. So you carry that. So, you know, but I don't mind if some show is good, some nice person is doing it in a very professional manner, with a good models and all. So then, you know, then a different scenario completely, because we are also like India, we do show larger than life, you know, as you see my show on YouTube, you know. So like, yeah, American has been a more business trip for me. I'm not stationed in one city. I'm going to like 10-15 cities together, and then taking these bags from one city to another city. It's not a cakewalk. It's just a tough job.
It's a tough job. It's a tough job because it's a very big country here, and it's not easy to just travel carry those big bags from one place to
another. Over here, we get bodyguards, we get four servants in the front, four servants in the back. We have got managers, we have got everyone. America, mein toh, you have to do gada mazuri by your own self. You know, you have to.
It's too hard here.
Tough, we are quite diva in our country here, but it's very tough in the United States. You need to leave everything. But you know, I have made such great friends in America, like Mini Didi, like Didi, I would stay with her, and she is a darling. And like Janak Bedi was hosting me last time, you know, and like you are there, I worked with you, and there are a couple of hosts, like Shai Khan is there, very nice Shai Khan. Udya Shivani is like a godmother to me because she's the one who made me star in America. So like Nishi Behl is there. Nishi Behl is a very nice lady. I never worked with her professionally, but I made such good friends because whenever I have given them a call, they have never said no for me. Because I'm very nice to them. You know, it's all about the relationship, Kataran Didi. Life is too short. You need to like understand that you make friends. Business hua nahi hua, wo meri kismat ki baat hai. But you know, you make friends.
Yeah. It's important to have good friends around you who are going to help you, who is going to come to you, who is there for you all the time.
So Haji was hosting me. So she was a club. She has her own terms and conditions. But you know, I think so. Everybody in America is there to make money because you have left your India and you are there to make money. So I'm not against of their terms and conditions. But the designer come with the mindset of selling the clothes. You know, they don't want to see that kind of politics. What is in the city. You know, end of century, you know, you just sell your clothes. You want to come back happily with your Jimmy Choo purse and like, you know, your LB bag. So, you make that much money. Oh, God. Like, oh, I made this much money. I deserve a bloody LB bag. You know, that's very important. Yeah, but I'm very happy-go-lucky person.
Yeah, I have seen you that way actually. You're always happy, you're always smiling, and
चलता है दीदी nothing because मेरे को कोई बच्चे पैदा करके
school बिंदास
या कि मेरे को
बिंदास personality
responsibility है या
अब that is
हुआ तो हुआ अभी ये lockdown में कितना business नुकसान हुआ जो होगा सो होगा but yes अगर कुछ चीज बुरी हो रही है तो आगे से अच्छा भी होगा. If something is bad happened to you, good will also happen. God is not, there's no, he will never do injustice to you.
Yeah. Acha, aapki fashion was the most talked about movie about you. Apart from that, you have done Leela, Do you have any memories, anything which you want to do something different and unique about you?
Didi, I'm doing a movie with Netflix now, which I'm not supposed to talk. I'm featured. It's a very big series. So, like, just signed me. So, you will see me over there. It will be most talked about series. And I'm very, very excited for that project. I'm also doing one Hollywood project called Dollhouse. Okay. So, yeah, I'm doing a part of my designing. So, God has been kind and just like whatever is coming to my kitty, I'm just signing everything because I have to, end of the day, you know, I have to take care of 55 poor people who work for me. End of the day, are reliable on me. And I have to pay for them. And that's all, you know, I got out of the way to sell my clothes, to struggle so much. Or else God has given me enough that even if I take a retirement right now, I can eat very well. But if you're taking the responsibility of 55 people, you know, you have to take responsibility. They're poor people. They have daily wages. You need to work till the time your bones are completely all right and your body has not given up. So you have to work for those poor people. Because I'm very fortunate that Lord Krishna has given me this empowerment or power to run 55 houses. How many? I'm just 38 right now. How many people in 38 years can run 55 houses? So this is God has given me this opportunity and they are the karigars work for me. And I'm very, very excited when I pay them salary and when I make money for them. That's the biggest happiness of life.
How are you dealing with right now? Because it's a pandemic going on. And are you still giving them the salaries? Are you still working on your designs? Are you still going to your...
March and April, I gave them March, April, May, I gave them full salary, but June, I gave them 50%. You know, okay. I gave them 50%. But yes, and even in July, I will give them 50%. So I am very like, I'm not kind of a person who will make money and who will want to eat everything by himself. So I want to...
You're all the friends are just saying something to you, and I can see it on your face. So, don't you feel that this is the right time for you to think about new designs?
I'm coming up with next
selection.
Didi, after Sindurkin, I'm launching Vrindavan. That's my next collection. Yeah, that's my next Vrindavan. Yeah, I'm launching Vrindavan now. After Vrindavan, I'm going to launch collection Dakar Bui, which is based on the red light area. So these are the things which are coming out in this season. And I'm sure somebody will take an inspiration and launch before me, but I care a damn. I go 110.
Nobody can touch and think about what you have there in your mind. You know that
exactly.
It's not easy to imitate.
So I'm already preparing the collection, but the situation in my country is so bad right now in Bombay. You have no idea how many people are dying here. I'm just praying to God that everything should become all right and vaccines would come out soon. And there's a lot of tension, especially the city in Bombay is really very, very tough, and we are dealing with a lot of issues over here.
So you have worked in the serials also, the daily serials, the operas, kind of like Is Desh Mein Hoga Chaand, Bekhna, Ek Hazaar Mein Meri Behna Hai. These are the serials that you have done. So what is the difference between
myself, because this was like 15-20 days roles they have given me, where the designer Rohit Verma is coming and he was grooming and transforming the people. So I was being very myself in that. So and always they have approached me TV series. When the boss has serials could turn down me, like TV is not my cup of tea. But the thing is this, I think so, but when you are in a small parda, you become famous, and it's always like for me, fashion designing is my first love. All right, and when your face becomes very common, then people recognize you more, and that's the reason I do TVC.
So, what do you find the difference between designing for a movie and doing the designing for a serial?
So, serial is very, very tough because serial is very easy because there's one mood board they give you, and you have to design according to that. Movies are very tough because you need to satisfy nearly 7 people. Cinematographer, director, producer, heroine's tantrum. So, you know, you can satisfy one person, you cannot satisfy 7 because every 7 will have a different opinion completely. So, first of all, you need to understand in inverted commas what is the movie board is all about. I have never enjoyed doing Bollywood. I have turned on very big banners. Because it's a lot of stress. Because things are not very well planned. Because they will just call you 11 o'clock and they will tell you, oh, 8 o'clock, you have to send a police wala ka dress. So 11 o'clock in the night, they're calling. So it's very, very tough to do Bollywood movies. And people who have got big production houses, they've got big setup where the 24 hours, karigars are working. You can do it. You can create a police wala dress in 8 hours. For me, I have mental peace. I'm more on the red carpet. A lot of Hollywood heroes wear my clothes on red carpet. So I'm a red carpet designer. I have turned down big banners. Big banners, I'm not naming them, they will feel offended. And I was offered when I would have been a star all over the world. I have turned down that also. For me, my mental peace is very important because I'm a creative person. I cannot work in a pressure.
Because you have to have those wings, you have to fly, and you have to have a lot of imagination.
Charan Devi is so tough, I can't tell you. It's very tough, believe me. It's very tough, and because you have got so much. And कभी कभी क्या होता है, you have to for one sim you have to create three clones, because clones का check कर दे. So for if I'm doing Priyanka's clothes, for instance, instance like I did Sunny Leone, ये सैया superstar what she's wearing, ये सैया superstar by लहंगा. So like I had to make two lehengas like that, similar. So stop because एक लहंगा फट गया था. एक हमेशा हमेशा बैकअप पे होना चाहिए डांसर्स के लिए.
नहीं, that is right. Yeah, बैकअप के लिए अगर नहीं होगा तो by the way if it just get you know something happens is something still going on. Also, अच्छा, who is your favorite model you really want?
You always put me in the spot.
This
see, all heroines are good. They all are my favorite.
Play, you know, play with my designs.
Then everybody is good. Like you can say, very well dressed up heroine. My favorite will be Shilpa Shetty. Kangana is very good. Sunny Leone is very nice. Aishwarya is very good. They all have got their own unique sense of style, like Sonam Kapoor and all. So it's a very very unique style. So I cannot say anybody is my favorite. They all are my friends. So I will be like offending couple of them. And models, may I can say Jessie Randhawa is my favorite, and she'll be always very favorite of mine. And my favorite model to work with, I want to work with Winnie Harlow, because Winnie Harlow, she's a beauty. Because she's having a mask on her face, on her body, but still, you know, she's so gorgeous, she's so pretty, she walks so confidently. Like, I'm her biggest fan, you can say. So I like Winnie Harlow, which is my dream to work with. Okay, and also Kendall Jenner. I like Kendall Jenner. So yeah, so these two girls I really like.
They all are beautiful. Yes. Acha Rohit, you have a different thought and different style of design for men. I've really seen your work that it doesn't look like a feminine style. Also, it doesn't look but it has a flair, it has different cards, and it has a different unique style of design. So how did it came into your mind, and given that manly look also and for flair, how did all this come into your mind?
Like I said, when I start designing, I don't see left and right. Ideas keep on popping, and I just start designing. And I think today's man has also become very metrosexual. He is experimental. He wants to explore certain things. So why, when it comes to women's fashion, why not to give to the men something very different and unique? Because every man wants to be very stylish today. So that's the reason, you know, when I start designing, like in the country, and I'm known as master of cuts in India. So like, and that's the reason I've been awarded so many times. And I didn't know, I think it's a God gift. When I do certain things, it's just ideas keep on popping up, and like I start sketching, and garments come out well. I don't pre-plan my collection, Didi. I don't pre-plan my collection. So even if you see my Instagram as Rohit K. Verma, so you see on Instagram, you know, I whatever I create for the men, it's all a little different and unique.
Yeah. And we have recently seen your Sindoor Khela. And you had used that white and red color into it, and those flares. So,
Like I said, people say a donkey cannot praise his own tail. People say I'm a good designer. So when I was doing Sindoor Khela, it the name was very very unique. Sindoor is like Bengali people they play when Durga Ji goes. So yeah. Like the whole concept, like the white and red thing, white stands for peace, red stands for love. The whole collection was like that. I had transgenders walking the ramp. I had acid victim walking the ramp in that show. So the whole show was talking about, the whole show was very dramatic and very done in a very, very emotional manner, and it got viral. But even my Mahakumbh, if you see, when I did Mahakumbh, it was talk of the town. And even if I did the Mela collection, I did, it was talk of the town. It was Valley of Shadow, I did before that. It was talk of the nation. But thing is, because of the Times of India, who was a very, very strong as a media, and the whole show became viral, people started talking about it.
But it was a family show. Yeah, it was a family show. And you had won a lot of awards also, like the Youngest Achiever of Asia, Asia Award, and then Rashtriya Shakti Award. So, what was the Rashtriya Shakti Award?
The Rashtriya Shakti Award was given by the ministers of Maharashtra. It's the whole designers of the Maharashtra, they compete for it. I won that. But I think these awards and all, like, I go and receive it, and like, I have got nearly 75 awards. But I think awards and all is okay. Like, it's okay, they appreciate your work and all. But end of the day, what is your happiness is like when your client comes and kisses your forehead, and he's happy. She's happy in a bridal outfit, or she's happy with the fittings. And oh God, I got a lot of compliments. That's the best happiness than these awards. Actually, I'm not being fake. I've been very honest about it. The awards can come and go. But the appreciation what you get from the crowd, appreciation what you get from your clients is the biggest happiness one can ever get.
Yeah, that is true. Your name, when people really take your name with respect, with love, that is very, very important. And when people wear your design, they say, okay, this is so broken. This is what happiness is, right? When people start appreciating your work, that makes them more, happy than rather than all the awards that you get.
Yes. Yes, you're right.
Yes. You have just told me about the Vrindavan collection. So, is it going to be about Krishna and around that? Because the name itself is saying.
It's dedicated to Lord Krishna, how he used to do Rasas and all. But the whole collection will be very vibrant, very, very unique, very different, very inspired by that era, but giving a modern touch to it. So, you know, like that. So I just like I lost my collection Draupadi. My Draupadi collection was also very talked up the town when I did it for the Colors TV. So when I did Draupadi, people said, okay, what collection? When the garments came on the runway, people went crazy. So it had beautiful lehenga with a different cholis and a different dupatta, 3-3 dupatta draped in a very different manner. So my name is Draupadi. So now Vrindavan, just wait and watch.
Yeah, many people are really waiting for that collection to be seen, you know, and I'm very, very excited because you have a different style and all your designs are different from what you have done previously. So, what do you want to say to the newcomer? A lot of people are just imitating the big designers. So, what do you want to say to them?
Always, I believe that always follow your dreams, always believe in yourself, create your own identity. We all are creative in our own way, and always believe that you are the best. And the confidence what you have, because end of the day, your happiness lies in your own hand. And you need to be sure what you want to do in life. Because if you are not very confident within your own self, you cannot be very successful in life. Whether whatever is your individuality, whatever your personality, whatever you are within, you need to explore yourself and you need to answer your own queries, because you are your best friend. Nobody is your friend. You have to only help your own self. So obviously, through your confidence and your creativity and your research matters a lot. And just follow your dream and you'll be very successful.
Thank you so much, Rohit. It was such a lovely talking to you. In the last, do you want to say anything to your fans or your lovers who wants to reach out to you? And when is your next show coming up here in the US?
Next year now. Tarandini, next year. So yeah. Let's see next year.
I know, because abhi to kuch nahi hone wala
hai. Yes. Maybe next year. Yes.
So do you want to say anything to your fans right now?
No, nothing. I just want to say, just be happy, be confident, love yourself, and be beautiful. All are beautiful in our own way. And always remember that Lord Krishna will always bless you if you follow His footpath. And yes, and karma always pays you always back. And do good deeds. That's all.
Thank you so much for being here in the show, Dita and Talks with Tara. It was a pleasure talking to you, and we got to know lots about you.
Thank you, Didi. Thank you, Mari.
Yeah, see you soon, bro. Bye-bye. Yes, that was Rohit, is designer of Bollywood. He has won many awards. He has done fashion designing for a lot of movies. That is Fashion Dhun, Leela, Style and Dhadkan. So we had a great, great conversation. We got to know about him, his personal life, his professional life, and about what he wants to do next in life. His new collection, which is going to be Vrindavan, and the other collection, he's just doing a lot of movies also, one Bollywood movie also. So let's wait for his next collection, and I'll be back again next week with another celebrity, another any personality who has made their mark in the industry or in the life. So bye-bye, take care, and thank you all for joining.